So, in closing, I really want to thank you all again, as I do every meeting, for your support and allowing us to do what we do. And we'll thank the communities of Chum and Anito for, and I should say Mangote too, because the people stay there, for allowing us to come into your communities and invade you for a few weeks every year, and everybody enjoys it, so.
Thank you, Tim. Questions or comments for Mr. Tenney?
Yes, I'd like to comment, because I was an attendee at the meeting the other day of the Historic Preservation Coordinating Committee, still trying to get that down right. And it's extraordinary the number of projects that are going on. You're just seeing the tip of the iceberg on what Tim has mentioned today. And I also am happy to hear a new definition of a cab ride. I think that's commendable that we now have and thanks to what Craig is doing in that regard. There is one of the projects that we discussed, and that Commissioner Elbrock was not at the meeting, and I know he's involved in it, and that is the lava pump house work. For those of you not familiar with it, it's a stone building, the easiest way to put it, that's on the Los Pinos River, about 400 feet vertically below the railroad, and some, I don't know, quarter mile distant for a pipeline that carries the water up from the Los Pinos, traditionally to Lava Tank. And the Friends have been working in SHPO's guidance to restore this lava stone building and making great progress. But Mother Nature's not been cooperating with us, and the Los Pinos Creek has been moving closer to the site of the pump house. And it's something that we've started, the Friends especially, have written up some very thorough analysis on this, but they are having to look to the Corps of Engineers and have enlisted Commissioner Elbrock's assistance, since Billy clearly is a guy who knows water up in the San Luis Valley from his responsibilities with the Bureau of Reclamation. And I was hoping Billy might comment on, is this something we need to wait till spring to get a better sense of, or what does it look like to you?
Well, it's just a volume of paperwork that's required to go through the Corps of Engineers, and the Friends have started some of it, and we'll just have to continue working with them and all their requirements. It's the main paper is a FERC 404 permit, which is the Clean Water, part of the Clean Water Act. So we'll have to get that filed, and some other paperwork that's required.
Yeah. Do we have any notion of how long it takes before we get some kind of assessment, or if we, not being a water guy, I don't know if that building's in danger or not. How do we get to that goal?
It shouldn't take too long. I say too long, a couple of months. I don't know if they're going to have to go out and assess it. They've been out there before.
I see.
I don't know if they're going to have to make another trip out there. I don't know what the winter's going to bring. If they can get out there this winter, it might be spring. We just have to get paperwork into them and let them set their own schedule. They will be made aware that time is of the essence, and so
yeah.
I don't think the pump house, unless we have a exceptional winter like we did last year, I don't think the pump house is in jeopardy this year, but
okay.
It's definitely something that needs to be taken care of.
I want to thank the Friends for bringing that to our attention and concerns about that.
Well, but yeah, kind of by accident. But.
Anything else for Tim? Thank you, George.
Yeah, I have a brief comment. I wanted to extend a huge thank you to you and the Friends. In August, I believe it was, you guys had a work session going on in Antonino. I'm sure there was one here in Chama that same week. and I believe it was Wednesday of that week, one of your members came over to the commission office and invited myself and Becca, my assistant, over for lunch.
Oh, yes.
And we came over and went into the facility. Everybody was busy as beavers, and we went over and we totally, totally enjoyed the lunch that they served.
You had hamburgers, probably.
I think it was actually, no, I think it was actually like a, kind of like a barbecue beef on a bun, if I remember. And it said it was the same thing they offered every week, the same that day. So it might not have been a Wednesday and such, but everybody was extremely friendly and I really appreciated it.
Oh, well, I'm glad you could make it over. We've got a very loyal group that work in Antonito and in our facility over there, which has been up 13 years now. So, yeah, once they get over there and they find out how nice it is to not have to work out in the wind and the conditions, they really enjoy it. It was a little like pulling hen's teeth at first to get folks over there, because a lot of our members like being in Chaman working in the yard, but now we have a bunch of folks that just love Antonito because of that building. So anyway, well, thanks, George, and they'll continue to invite you guys over. So.
Anything else?
Yeah, I've got
yes,
one
John.
More. I would like to point out, first of all, thanking the Friends for everything they do. And truly, they are, this is a perfect example of Tom Sawyer's fence, what they do to come and work on here and bring not only the materials and the labor, the money that it takes to make this happen and support the community. But a quick over the thumb look at this. The roadable fleet, which got mentioned, is now up to somewhere between 55 and 60 cars. Now, to put that in perspective, that would require a 4-locomotive train to get it from Chama to Cumbres. So they are pushing us now to make sure they have so many cars available that they are pushing the limits of our fleet. Would we want to move them all at one time? Anyway, thank you very much for the things that
well,
you guys are doing.
When you think about it.
So someday we'll have to do a charter where we put them all together and get enough engines out at the same time to move
it. But don't expect too many more.
Thank you, Tim. Thank you. Next on the agenda, we will ratify the 2017 pricing and scheduling plan